Hello everyone, welcome to the course Data Structures. This is N. Tulsi Chitra, Associate Professor, Department of CSIT, MLR Institute of Technology. Let us see today's overview of the course. Today we will be seeing about the implementation of double linked list operations, insertion operations. In the previous session, we have already discussed about how you are going to perform the insertion operations. And we have four different ways of inserting a new node in the double linked list. Now we are going to try to implement the code here. Let us everyone open the online C compiler GDB. Already we did some program over there, and we will be continuing in that program itself. Yes, let us open online C compiler GDB. In the previous session, we have already completed this program regarding double linked list creation and display, right? And now in the same program, we are going to implement all our insertion operations, okay? Let us start here in the comment session itself. I am giving the insertion operations also. Okay, let us include all the insertion operations which we are going to perform. Void insert begin, then insert end, insert after, then insert before. Okay, these are the four functions where we are going to implement, and we know this is how where you are going to declare the node structure. Once you can refer the previous video for all these things, what are the pointers and all these things. And here I am going to write one more printf statement for our insertion operations, all the insertion operations, okay, printf. And what is the choice we have? Fourth choice, that is insert begin, and the fifth one, insert end, then sixth one, insert after, then the last one where we have is insert before. Okay, these are the different insertion functions where we are going to implement. At the same time, include this all these operations in the cases also. Case 4 is insert begin, then break dot function, then case 5 insert end, okay, then case 6 insert after, then last case, case 7, we have insert before, right? Four functions we are going to implement now. Next, here the choice value should be changed. Here we have included some more cases, that's why this should be until less than or equal to 7, okay? And this is how where we are going to create a node in the double linked list. This is already we have seen the forward display and the backward display. Now try to write the functions for insert begin. Insert begin. first try to create the node, that is by using malloc function, allocate the memory and create a node. That means by using struct node pointer, malloc of size of struct node. Okay. Now we need to read the data value. Please give enter data value. Then read the data value of it. Address of n arrow data. And initially we need to assign n arrow next equal to null. At the same time we need to give n arrow previous equal to null. Okay, this is how node to be created. Now make the connections for this. First we are going to make the previous connection, that is head arrow previous. Head arrow previous equal to n arrow next equal to head, and the last we need to make the new node which we have created as head node. Yes, once if you want to make the connections properly, once check the previous video session, okay, so that you can easily understand what we are writing here. This is for insertion begin. Next, void insert end. Here also we need to allocate the memory. The same part should be repeated. The above which we have mentioned, node pointer, malloc of size of struct node. Same, read the data value, enter data value, read the data value also, address of n arrow data, then n arrow next equal to null, and n arrow previous equal to null, right? Based on this, the node will be created and data part will be read, and next and the previous are assigned to null. Now this node should be added at the end of the list, right? We know that first make the connections, last node n is n arrow previous is going to be assigned to last. Then here the previous node will be last node, right? Last arrow next equal to n, and the new node which we have added, that should be the last node. That's why we need to assign last equal to n. This is another function. Next, void insert after, right? For every insertion, we require this part, right? That is allocating the memory. This part is mandatory. That's why I'm just copying it. And here, when I want to insert a new node, we require a key, right? That's why int key value. We are declaring it in the function itself. Here itself, we require the key value. That's why I'm not declaring it globally. Now, first read the key value, enter key, read the key value, key is read. Now, assign our temp value to head. Now, to traverse through the list and check for our key value, we need to traverse through the list by using our while loop until temp not equal to null. Now here check for our key value is there in the list, that is the link double linker list or not. For that we are going to check with the data, temp arrow data equal to key. If this is key, then break. Key value is found, then we are going to terminate the loop. Otherwise, we are going to move our temp to the next location. Temp equal to temp arrow next. Okay. And if you are coming out of the loop, we need to make the connections here. First, make the right connection, then the left connection. Right. And what is the right connection we have? N arrow next equal to temp arrow next. Then we have on the right hand side itself, we need to make one more connection, that is temp arrow next arrow previous. Temp arrow next arrow previous equal to N. This is one side. Right connection is completed and now we need to make the left connection. What do we have? We have the name as temp and another one is N, right? Now make the connection for N arrow previous. N arrow previous equal to temp. And another one is we have temp arrow next equal to N. These are the four connections which we need to make, and these two and that two, these two connections are right connections and the remaining two are the left connections. Okay. The last one where we have is insert before, and here also we are going to have the same. This should be required, memory to be allocated, everything will be the same. That's why just I am copying it here. Here also we require the key value, that's why I have copied the key value also. Right, allocating the data memory, data value and reading the data part and assigning it to null. And here we require the key, here also we need to take the key value, enter key. And read the key value by using scanf. Address of key. Then followed by. Now again assign temp equal to head. Now we need to traverse through the list. While temp not equal to null. Now check for the key value is there in the list or not by using temp arrow data equal to key. If key element is found, then terminate the loop by using break. Else, if not the case, then assign temp to p1, p1 equal to temp, and at the same time we are moving temp to temp to next location, temp equal to temp arrow next, right? Now again we need to make the connections here. Okay, terminating the loop. After that we need to make the connections here. One is p1 and another one is temp, and the below one is n value. Assume that diagram what we have, right? First make the right connections. What is the right connection we have? The name of that one is temp. Temp arrow previous. Temp arrow previous equal to N. Then N arrow next equal to temp. Okay. This is right connection where we are going to make. And coming to the left connection. Coming to the left connection. Here we have P1 arrow next equal to N, next N arrow previous equal to P1, right? This is how we are going to make the connections, right? Before going to execute this, here we have declared one pointer variable called p1. This has to be declared before within the function, otherwise I am going to declare it globally. Here I am going to declare it globally directly in the structure. Here I am going to declare it directly. That is the name of that one is star p1. Okay, let us save this program. Right, saved. Try to run the program. Select the language as C. Run it. Once we'll check, is there any errors? Is some semicolon is missing at line number 134? 1 minute. 134. Yes. Yeah, semicolon missing. Still anymore. In 144, arrow. Temp arrow next is here itself. It's missing. Run. Yes, it is asking for the choice. Now we'll check only the four operations are working or not, right? First one, let us create some three nodes, and after that we are going to try to implement the remaining four operations, right? First 10, again 20, 30. Try to display in the forward direction itself. The forward display is 2, 10, 20, 30. Now give the enter your choice value as 4, right? 3 is backward display, 4 is insert at the begin. Enter the data value. Suppose I have given it as 5. Enter choice to display. I am displaying 2. Yes, 5 is inserted at the beginning. If you can see here, 5 is inserted at the beginning of the list. Next choice 5. Enter the data value. 5 is, it has to insert at the end, right? I want to give the data value as 40. Let's try to display it. Yes, 40 is inserted at the end of the list, right? Then coming to enter your choice 6. Now, I want to insert the element after a given key element, right? Now, I am going to choose my data value as some 25. Sorry. Enter data value as 25. You search for the key after which key element you want to insert. Suppose I have given it as 20. Yes, now it has to be inserted after 20. Now let us display it. Yes, 25, 10, 20, and 25 has been displayed. Now choice value as 7. Now give the data value. Suppose I have given it as some 28. Now before which key element you want to insert? I want to insert before 30. Now try to display it. Yes, now you could see here. Before 30, 28 is inserted, right? Like this way, we can do the implementation of all the insertion operations, okay? Once try to implement this program. Yes, in this session, we have seen about how to perform the implementation of double linked list insertion operations. If you are trying to implement this double linked list insertion operations, before that you need to check for the previous video, then only you can easily implement this one, okay? While doing implementation, if you are getting any errors, please give some in the comments so that we can rectify it, okay? Thank you.